Welcome to another tutorial in my tutorial series AutoCAD 2D technical drawing. And in this tutorial I would like to show you how you can align some drawing elements, and in this certain task we would like to align those elements in the first step and then mirror it to create such a truss, and at the end we would like to group all the elements together. Okay, let's start with the alignment. And here I would begin with the classical way. I use the commands move and mirror and rotate. Let's do this. At first I select my elements. This is actually a group. Yeah, we will talk about this later. So it's enough that I click at one line and all the other lines which are grouped together will be selected. And now I go to the move command, and it asks me for my base point. I use my object snap here, endpoint, and select this point here, and now I move it to my zero point. So hit in the command line, I just hit the 0,0, and now this point is already in the right position. Now I have to rotate it. So let's go to rotate, and it asks me to select my objects. I enter the letter P, that means the previous. It will be select my previous selection of my command I did before. And now I can add some additional objects. I don't want to, that's why I hit enter again. And now it wants me to specify my let's rotate it. Actually, I wanted to mirror it, but okay, we can also do the rotation now. So the base point is this one. This is the point which is already in the right position. And now I have to enter the angle. I don't know it, that's why I use a reference. I click on reference, and it's always easier if you use some reference to start from the base point. So I click at this point, and then I use this reference line. And this should be somewhere here at the in the horizontal position. I could use my grid snap to snap somewhere here. But if you want, if you don't have a grid, then you can also use the auto. And now I can click here. So let's turn this off here, because now you should know how this truss look at the end. So we don't need the screenshot anymore. And turn this off. Okay, now we have some more easier to say. At this the last step we can mirror this. Just select it and now go to mirror, and it asks me to first point of my mirror line. This is this one here, and the second one is this one here. And you can also use the auto if you don't have a second point. I turn this off because I have a second point. And now it asks me if I'd like to erase the original one. In this case, it makes sense. So yes, erase it. And now this is in the right position. Okay, we used together, I think, three different steps or commands. We started with move, then we rotated and mirrored it. Actually, I wanted to move, then rotate, and then mirror. No, sorry, a move and a mirror and then rotate. But it doesn't matter. You can change the order as you want. I like to show you another way, which is actually a little bit quicker. And let's undo this. So, and if we have again turn off this screenshot. So, and make this a current layer. And yes, and this is the align command. Actually, this align command, it's not so, in my opinion, it's not so very well known in AutoCAD, because it's a little bit, it's hidden here. If you here are the most popular commands, and if you need more, then you have to expand this. And here is the align command. Let's try this one. At first, have a look at the because if you hover over it, then it shows you some quick info about this command. And you see you need at least two points yeah, for alignment. Yeah, this drawing means that there are some points you have to specify. It means that the point one should be at the position two and the point three at the position four. But let's do it. Maybe it's easier to understand if I show it. So, oh, I've forgotten to hit to click on it. So just click. Now we have here on the align command. It wants me to align the object. So click at this group, hit enter to finish the subcommand to select the objects. Now it asks me for the first source point. My first source point should be this here. And where should it be? It should be at this 0, comma 0 point. So enter 0 comma 0. Maybe you can see it. There's a white line from this point to this point. The second point is should be this one here, and where should this be? It should be here at the line. The exact point I don't know. Of course, I can measure it, and then I can enter the coordinate, but it's not necessary. Yeah, it's enough if you click at one point at this line. So I use my grid snap and click at just one point here, and now maybe it's easier to for you to see. This is my guideline here. And turn off the object snap, the grid snap. And now the third point should be this one here, and this should be somewhere at this line here. So again, turn on my grid snap and click here, and that's all. Yeah, maybe you see this is actually a shortcut. Yeah, with this command, I did all in one. Yeah, and that's why. And at this certain case, this is much quicker. And I told you in this here in this quick info, actually there are only two points. Yeah, there is you don't have to use three points. So let's do it again. This time with this line here. And so hit the right key, no, not the right button on my mouse and the recent input, and then again to go to align. If it's the last. Here you see all the commands you have already done before, and align. Use align now. Just click at this line and hit enter. And now I use. Sorry, I have to turn off my grid snap. And now I use this point should be here, and this point should be here. Now I have only second points, and there's no need for a midpoint and so on, or for a third point. You can stop here. It asks you for a third point, but you can just hit enter. But if you enter only two points, then here there is another possibility because now it asks you if you like to scale it. And if I say yes or no, in this case it makes no sense, yeah, because the line has the right length. But anyhow, yeah, if you use three points, there's no possibility to scale. This you should know. If you use two points, then you can scale it, but if this is actually only a one-dimensional element, yeah. But if you use such an element for alignment and you only use two points, then in our case, this drawing could be at this side of this line. If I use those two points, yeah, for the alignment and not this one anymore, so only those two points, then actually the possibility could be that it could be if this is my alignment line here, then it could be at this side of this line or below this line. Yeah, this is the disadvantage if you use only two points. The advantage is then that you can scale it. Yeah, this you should take in consideration. If you have the possibility of 3 points and there's no need to scale, then I would always use 3 points. If you have only 2 points, then use 2 points. Maybe it's at the wrong side, then you have to mirror it. But if you want to scale it as well, then 2 points is the best option. Okay, in our case, it doesn't make any difference because in this line, it's okay. So let's say no. Now, and now it's in the right position. Okay, so far about the align tool. Now let's finish this truss here because we need the second part or the right part of the truss. For this, let's mirror it. I click at this the left part, go to mirror and specify my mirror line using this point and this point with my object snap. And now it asks me to delete it. I don't want this case. I don't want to say no. And this is done. Yeah. If you want, you can also group all those elements together that it makes easier to select them. Maybe if you want to, if you need this, then a group might be quite useful. As you see here, this is already a group. Yeah, if you click on it, then you have only one selection point and you can move it to a certain, to another location and so on. This is quite useful, as you have seen this before. Yeah, when I used the commands move, rotate, mirror, or align, I had only I could select all those elements at once. Yeah, and this is an advantage of a group. Let's undo this and talk a little bit about groups, and later we will make our own group. And if you go to the Home tab here, you find the groups. There you can create new groups. This is this one, but you can also edit or manage your groups. Yeah, the first command here is to ungroup the elements. That means to delete the group. I can select this group here, then I click ungroup, and now the elements are the group is deleted, and you can you find all the elements single access. Yeah. And let's undo this. So if you don't need this group anymore, this is okay. But if you would like to only to have access to each single element, and then it's not a good idea just to ungroup it and to group it again. The better way is this command here. You can enable or disable the group selection. Now the group selection is on, and if I can only select the group, yeah, but I can still turn this off like now, and now there is I can select all each element by its own, yeah, and there is actually no group selection anymore. Now I can select this and maybe move this elsewhere, and this maybe as well, and if I turn this on, now we have our group again. Yeah, this is better. Yeah, ungrouping means that you really delete it, and you this you use if you don't need this group anymore. But for only for selection purpose, this is actually the better way. Let's undo this. And here, if you like to edit the group, let's choose this one. Now I have to select the group. And here you can add elements to your group. You can remove elements from your group, or you can also rename the group. Yeah, you can change its name. Maybe just add this line here to show you how it works. I go click at add an object, click at this line. Did I select it? And now I hit enter, and this should be part of my group now. Oh, I have to enable this, and as you see, this line is now part of my group. Let's undo this. Let's have a single line again. So this is about this part. No, this part here. And here you find some other stuff. For instance, the group manager and the group box. Yeah, that's maybe first the group box. You can turn this off. Yeah, you see if I click here, you see this box here. Yeah, this is this rectangle around the elements. If you don't like this, you can disable it. And now, if I click at my group, there is no box anymore. Yeah, but the group is still active. Yeah, if you use this one here. So I like this box. That's why I turn this on. So the last option here is the group manager. And here you see all the named groups, and if you would like to see also the unnamed, then you can hit you can enable this option here, and it includes also unnamed group. Yeah, see this group for instance now is actually was created as we mirrored this group, then we created a new group. Yeah, this is a difference to blocks. Yeah, if somebody of you knows already the blocks, then if you the block you have only one in once in your drawing, but groups if you copy them you have again a new element, yeah. And that's why it is as we mirrored this group, it created a new one without a name, and it was an unnamed group. Yeah, this you have to take in consideration. But if you want, you can change its name. So let's change the name. Let's at first copy this one. Now here, enter the new name, call it right. This is the right part of my truss. Now click in rename. And here is the left part, is the right part. If you don't know what is what, you can select the group and then you can say highlight, and you see this is actually the right part. Now this is highlighted. Continue. And yes, you can create I think new groups. You can also do directly from here. You can also add and remove elements here. So this actually this group manager combines also some of the possibilities you have here. Okay, let's hit enter and make a new group. Yeah. At first, I like to show you a way which is not so good. Yeah, but I want to show it to you, and then maybe I'd show you a better workflow. It could be that you select all the objects you like to group. Yeah, and then you go to new group. And this is done. Yeah, and if I click on it, now I have a new group. But if you do it that way, then this is an unnamed group. Yeah, and if you go to the group manager, this is my new group here. Then if it's okay for you, then you can do this. If you don't need all those names, then it's okay. You can work with unnamed groups. I don't like it. I prefer to name them because then I have easier access here, and I don't have to look what is what. And that's why now I had to rename it. That's why I would like to show you a better way. Yeah, let's hit cancel and undo this, or maybe you can just ungroup it to this time. Hit ungroup. So, and now we have, yeah. There's three elements. So the better way is not to select the objects before. Go to group, and now you can at first here use this parameter to enter the name, and I call this truss. Hit enter. If you want also a description, but in this case we don't need it, so we skip this. And now I select the objects I would like to combine in a group. Tells me three elements, this group, and this single line. Hit enter, and oops, I'm afraid I did not undo this because it tells me that we already exist such a group. So I'm afraid this group is still, let's ungroup it. Okay. Let's have a look in the group manager. Now it's gone. Okay. Yeah, because the problem is that I did not really ungroup it. I did something wrong. And so I still had this alt group truss. And okay, let's do it again. Now, also go to group, name, call it truss. And now I select my objects. And I have two groups. Now it should work. Hit enter. And now has been created. Let's have a look in the manager. Here we are. This is my new group. It is named. And here, if I go to highlight, you see these are my group. And now I can select all those elements at once and work with it. Yeah, move it to another location and so on. Yeah. Okay, so far about groups, and I thank you for your attention, and maybe see you in another tutorial. Goodbye.